In this video, we will start with a simple game that just draws a ball on the screen and the user can move the ball by using the arrow keys. If we look at the code here, we will see that there is nothing fancy about it. We have a key down and the key up handlers. So when the user press the left key, we set the velocity, the horizontal velocity of the ball to minus 100 pixels per second, so the ball keeps moving to the left, and accordingly we do the same thing for the other arrow keys. And we have a key up handler, so that when the left or the right arrow key are released, we set the horizontal velocity to zero, so that the ball will stop moving horizontally, and the same happens for the up and down arrow keys. So what we are going to do here is to give the user the opportunity to define his own keys for moving the ball. For the moment, the arrow keys are hard-coded into the program, and we will change that by defining a dictionary. Initially, this dictionary will have the same keys as we have right now, which means the arrow keys. So we define left to be the left arrow key, right to be the right arrow key, up to be the up arrow key, and down to be the down arrow key. Next, we will update the code in the key down handler and the key up handler, so that it now uses the dictionary we defined earlier. And now we will check to see if the code still works. As you can see here, the ball keeps moving the same way it did before. So why did we do that? The difference now is that the arrow keys are not hard-coded into the key down and key up handlers, but instead those functions use the My Keys dictionary. The next step is to give the user the opportunity to redefine those keys. To do that, we will define a new variable that will be called setup keys, which will be false in the beginning, and we will also define a new key that when the user press that key, the program will enter a new state, the setup key state, where he will be presented with a screen that will allow him to change the keys. So we define here that the S key will be the key that will change the program state to the setup keys state. And so whenever this key is pressed, we will set the setup keys variable to be true. We also have to declare the setup keys as a global in the key down function. Now, if we are in the setup key state, we have to respond differently to the keys pressed by the user. So, if we ask the user to press a key in order to define the left key, this key must be stored into the My Keys dictionary. We could do that in the same key down handler we already have, but I will choose to create a new function that will be used as a key down handler whenever the program enters the key setup state. We will also need a new variable, the next key variable, that will tell our new function which key is to be defined next. So in our new keydown setup function, we will first store the key the user press as the newly defined key for the next key action. For example, if next key is currently the left key and the user presses a key, this key will be stored into the MyKeys dictionary. And from now on, the ball will move to the left whenever this key is pressed. And next, we have to change the value of the next key to point to the next key in our dictionary. So if next key equals to left, we will have to make it to be equal to right. If it is right, then it will be set up to up and so on. Now, if the user redefines the key for the setup also, which is the last key in our MyKeys dictionary, then we define the setup keys variable to be false, so that we return to the game. Now, while we are in the setup key state, we don't want anything special to happen whenever a key is released, so we will define a new key up function that will actually do nothing. Now, in our key down handler, we have already said that if the S key is pressed, then we enter the setup keys state. But we also have to redefine the key down and the key up handlers to our newly created functions, and of course we have to reset the next key to be the first key, which is the left. Okay, so now we will build a new function that will draw the setup screen to the user whenever the setup key is equals to true. We will name this function as draw underscore setup. Each time this function is called, will present a message to the user asking him to define a new key for the action that is currently stored in the next underscore key variable. So here we just draw a message on the canvas, on the center of the canvas. And of course, by this point, the key down underscore setup event handler is the active key down handler. So, when the user sees this message, whatever key he press next will be stored in the MyKeys dictionary, as we saw earlier in the key down underscore setup function. So the user is presented with this message. Let's say that currently the next underscore key is the left. So the user sees a message, press key for left. He press a key and the keydown underscore setup handler records that keystroke and stores it in the MyKeys dictionary. Next, the next key variable is given the value right. So the user sees the message, press key for right, and so on. And of course, in order to return to the game after the setup is finished, we have to set the setup keys to false and restore the original key down and key up handler so that our game works correctly. Of course, if we want our new behavior to be enabled, we will have to make a small modification to our draw canvas function. So if we are in the setup key state, the draw canvas function will just call the draw setup function and exits. Otherwise, it will act as before. So let's try that now to see if the game works correctly. Initially, we can see that the ball, the user moves the ball by using the arrow keys, and now we will press the setup key, okay, the S key, define key for left, right, up, and down, and for setup. And now we can see that the ball is moving with the newly defined keys. Okay, JK for left, right, and ED for up, down, respectively.